کسی که نایمده برای جا سبا یکی مثلا مریض باشه میگه این تبرکه مثلا آها. سه تا قاشق از این آش میخورن مریضشون برطرف میشه آرامش پیدا میکنن
Zoroastrian religious beliefs revolve around the sanctity of the four elements, fire, air, water, and the earth. That is why, until recently, when Zoroastrians died, they weren't buried in a traditional grave. Instead, they would be brought to this Tower of Silence, a lonely mountain top in the desert just outside the city. Zoroastrians believed that burying their dead would pollute the earth, and cremating them would pollute the air. So they would bring the bodies to the top of this hill for the vultures to devour. Bahram Demehri remembers what it was like when they used to carry their dead up here.
جسد رو میذاشتن اینجا
خب
جسد رو میذاشتن اینجا تا مراسم نهایی برگزار بشه و بعد از این پله ها میرفتن بالا دیگه ما هیچ کس حقی نداشت برتون و در طول زمان هم هیچ کس نرفته بود اینجا به صورت معمایی بود برای ما خب بفرمایید شما نه خواهش من بفرمایید
خیلی راحتی هم نبود
نه فرصت رای آخرته باید بریم ببینیم که این چیزی که برای ما معما بود چه شکلیه ببینید اونجا که می اومدیم حالا این سقف ببینید آثارش هست خودم یادمه مثلا 12 سالم بود که حدود 50 سال پیش میشه دیگه مادرم خدا بیامرز شد با همین ترتیب آوردنش آره مادر من اینجا هست
بله
خیلی متشکرم اجداد خودتونم دور تا دور اینجا کلاغا لاشخورا نشسته بودن بال پر میزدن که یکی برسه دیگه پس جسد رو که می آوردن تو ما اون وقت نمیتونستیم بیایم یک شخص رو میذاشتن اینجا
میذاشتن این گوشه ها مثلا
آره مثلا نه دقیقا میذاشتن رو این یه مرد میذاشتن اینجا بچه هم میذاشتن اینجا خب این شکلی
یعنی چند تا جسد رو با هم اینجا می آوردن
نه اگه یکی هم می آوردن اگه زن بود میذاشتن کنار دیوار وسط مثلا ردیف وسط مردا رو میذاشتن بچه‌ها میذاشتن نزدیکتر
این محوطه وسط برای چی آقای دمیری
عرض می‌کردم بعد از 6 ماه که اینجا پر می‌شده ببینید اینا رو درش رو می‌بستن می‌رفتن از اون یکی استفاده می‌کردن ولی لاشخور وقتی که خیلی از اجزای بدن رو می‌خوره استخون رو نمی‌تونه بخوره استخونا رو می‌ریختن تو این وسط که چاهمونن بوده و اینجا رو شستشو می‌کردن و تیزاب می‌ریختن رو این استخونا که محو بشه
اینجا شست رو دیگه
آره تیزاب هم که اسید قویه و بعد از 6 ماه دوباره اینجا رو باز می‌کردن اونو می‌بستن بله و این داستانی وسط
خب حالا اصولا این فلسفه دین زرتشتی که جسد باید در همچین جایی گذاشته بشه و دفن نشه به اصطلاح و لاشخورا اونو بخورن چیه برای چی
همه هدف اینه که 4 عنصر باد خاک آب آتش سالم بمونه و به محیط زیست کمک بشه من احساس شرمساری ندارم که مادرم اینجا هست اینجا بوده یعنی آوردنش اینجا و لاشخورا خوردنش حالا به قول یکی اون سیکل طبیعی رو اگه در نظر بگیریم و همه حیوانات همو میخورن خب انسانم حالا نمیگیم حیوانه ولی اجازه بدید که لاشخورا بخورنش
خب الان جسد رو دفن میکنن زرتشتی‌ها از کی در این محل نمیارن جسد رو که لاشخورا بخورن برای چی
از 45 سال پیش وقتی که زرتشتی ها مهاجرت کردن لاشخورا هم دیگه کم بودن دیگه اینجا متروکه شد ترجیح دادن که برن دفن کنن برای همین
Zoroastrians in Iran now are buried in graves lined with cement so that their bodies don't decompose into the ground still preserving the purity of the earth The dwindling numbers of Zoroastrians living in Yazd and sprawling urbanization seem to reduce the number of vultures visiting the Tower of Silence, so it became more practical to bury their dead after all. I am now heading down towards Persepolis, a few hundred kilometers south of Yazd, which lies on the way to Shiraz. On the way there sits the tomb of Cyrus the Great, the founder of the first Persian Empire. His tomb is being renovated by the authorities who are trying to preserve this ancient monument after widespread concern that humidity caused by a new dam nearby was damaging the stone. It's a modest tomb for such a great king, under whose dynasty the Persian Empire would grow to become the greatest and most powerful empire in the world. Cyrus the Great's prowess on the battlefield was legendary, but he is revered by Iranians for showing mercy to the civilizations he brought under his rule, particularly the Jews. He's credited with declaring the first human rights charter by abolishing forced labor and announcing freedom of religion for all the nations living within the Persian Empire. Persepolis is just a few kilometers down the road from Cyrus the Great's tomb. It is one of the ancient world's greatest treasures and the finest remaining example of the Persian Empire's craftsmanship. It was first designed by Darius the Great in about 500 BC as a base for his rule over his empire, which at the time was the largest empire in the world. But Persepolis was not a traditional capital. Rather, it is believed Persepolis' main function under Darius the Great may have been to provide a magnificent place where the most important of all the Zoroastrian festivals was celebrated, the New Year, or Nowruz, as it's known in Persian, which marks the beginning of spring. Representatives from every corner of the Persian Empire would gather here, bearing gifts to honor Shah-e-Shahan, the King of Kings.
The banquets that were held here at that time were really something to behold. They would feast on food and wine while dancing girls sang and performed for them. That was almost 2,500 years ago. It must have been a fantastic spectacle.
Dignitaries from as far away as Ethiopia, Cappadocia, India, and Arabia brought offerings for their emperor. But the glory of Persepolis did not last long. Less than 200 years after construction began, Alexander the Great and his mighty army swept into Persepolis. The area was burned down, and most of his treasures were looted. In fact, for centuries, this whole site was covered in sand and hidden from the eyes of the world. And it wasn't until about 70 years ago that archaeologists were able to reveal the splendor of this site once again. About 70 kilometers down the road is the old town of Shiraz, the fabled city of nightingales and poetry. Shiraz is well known for its atmosphere and vibrancy, the hustle and bustle creating the heartbeat of the city. It has a special place in the hearts of Iranians, and I've been looking forward to spending some time here. Its majestic mosques give Shiraz a grandeur that makes one understand why it was once the capital of Persia. The city has some of the most elegant and colorful mosques I've ever seen. It's also home to an imposing mausoleum, Shah-e-Chiragh, which is an important place of pilgrimage for Shia Muslims. The city became the capital of Persia in the late 18th century, under Karim Khan, ruler of the Zand dynasty, who set about making Shiraz a capital to rival Isfahan during its heyday under Shah Abbas the Great.
Karim Khan Zand wanted to be the people's king. He wanted to be popular and loved by his subjects. He even refused the grand title of Shah and instead took the name of Vakil-e-Ruaya, which means the people's deputy. Even this palace where I am now was not a normal palace. It was also his office. The army was based here. He wanted this to be a working palace.
It's no wonder Shiraz was dubbed the city of nightingales, roses, and poetry.